lift off. Take off. For making reverberations. Are we affirmative? No negatory. Come in, come in. Radio, what's your story? Ayahuasca kilo. Well, you will go. Are you ready for a better Beko Victor? Feeling wider than awake. Yeah, better quicken than straight.
Welcome, everyone, to Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania, and gorgeous PNC Park. We've got Father's Day baseball. It's the San Francisco Giants going up against the Pittsburgh Pirates. First pitch coming at you right after the break. Just about ready to go. And today on the hill, Mitch Keller. And Singy, we were talking earlier about how he's doing a great job navigating through tough spots.
I've just been so impressed with when it seems like there's more pressure, he's more calm and settles in. He's done an incredible job with runners in scoring position. Most guys, they get a little tight, they start to aim the baseball, but for some reason, he gets looser, the ball comes out of his hand with more life, and he's able to wiggle off the hook of, you know, tough situations and get his team back in the dugout.
Luis Gonzalez stands in here. Tried to hold back his swing there, but went around.
First pitch, 136.
And the next pitch is way outside. The 1-1. Swing and a ball lifted left field. No trouble here. Puts it away for the out. One down. Here's the Giants lineup. And Chris, this group has been struggling to put up runs lately.
Well, they haven't been on base a ton. And even when they are, they haven't been hitting very well with runners on base. So they need a guy or two to really step up, have some quality at bats, hit according to the situation, and sort of break out of this. I think if they do, the rest of this lineup will follow.
Mike Yastrzemski up here. Nope. Next offering is down low. 1-0. The 1-0. Just off the inside edge. Here's a strike at the knees. Strike one.
The fastball at the bottom of the zone can be very effective. Just got to keep it on the corners.
Kicks and deals. Swings through that, and it's a strikeout. Nice, efficient start to the afternoon. That's two out. And now it's Wilmer Flores.
The third baseman, Wilmer Flores.
This one in the air, center field. Reynolds on the move. Puts the squeeze on that one, and that'll end the inning. Giants down in order. On to the bottom of the first. No score. Bottom of the first. Pitching in our game today, Alex Cobb. Chris, what should we keep an eye on here with him?
His career ERA has been under 4. What I like most about him is his reliability. Takes the ball every fifth day, ready to go whenever the manager calls.
We go to the bottom of the first at the plate for Pittsburgh. Keep Ryan Hayes.
Hey.
And there's a strike. next offering upstairs.
Here we go.
Swings and sends a rocket to right. Tracks it down for the out. And a quick out number one.
Batting seven.
We take a check of the Pirates lineup put together by manager Derek Shelton. Singy, we're looking at a really young lineup here, so not much experience, but it also means they're going to bring a lot of energy to the table most days.
Well, we're in a golden age of young players. I mean, these players, they're getting up to the majors. They're dominating from a young age, bringing home plenty of hardware early in their careers. I mean, before they even get to free agency. So, you know, when you consider all of that, I love seeing the kind of energy that a team like this brings to the yard every day, day in and day out.
One down, base is empty. Strike two.
All right, now, he may have not liked either of those first two pitches or agreed with the umpire's calls, but at this point, he's going to have to bear down and be ready to hit anything close to the zone.
Chopper, right side. And he picks it up in foul territory. He swings and fouls one off. And the right-hander deals. And the 1-2 misses to even the count. Swing and a miss. Struck him out. Now two away.
Well, he should get some fist bumps when he gets back into the dugout, because even though he strikes out, he saw a lot of pitches and he battled. And this is a long haul where you're trying to get that pitch count up as early as possible. So gave the guys behind him an opportunity to see what's working for this pitcher or not. But I tell you what, it's a nice job right there.
Daniel Vogelbach stands in here, leaves that one down. To the right side, and he grabs it in foul ground. The 1-1. Hit well, right field, way back, and gone. Daniel Vogelbach leaves the yard, his ninth homer of the year, and they jump out front. It's 1-0.
His arms extended, and that's exactly what he did right there. You don't typically want to pull a pitch at that part of the plate, but he doesn't allow his wrist to roll over, stays through the ball, gets the loft, and gets the home run.
And it's Michael Chavis at the plate.
Batting fourth, the first baseman.
First pitch doesn't find the zone. Chavis drafted as a shortstop. Two outs. This to third. Reaches on the backhand, but it's through. In there safely.
I'm sure he feels really good about that one. Just found a way to slap that ball down the third baseline. That's really excellent back control, and it kind of goes back to all those drills you see hitters do off the tee where it's placed in different spots. That was just nice.
And stepping in, the rookie left fielder, Jack Sawinski.
Batting fifth, the left fielder.
And a foul ball.
Sawinski.
Left-hand hitter waits. Pitch misses, 1-1. Runner at second, two down. Next pitch is downstairs. Man at second.
Get ready for some action here. Good RBI guy at the plate. Runners in scoring position. And a hitter's count.
The 3-1. There's a strike. Two outs. And one in scoring position. On the ground, right side. Can't glove it cleanly, but they get the out at first, and that'll do it for the inning. Cannonball coming. It's now 1-0.
You can never be like me. Yeah, I push until I bleed. And I keep it so 100, not afraid to show my teeth. You can never be like me. Yeah, I push until I bleed. And I keep it so 100. Yeah, I got some enemies.
Second inning set to go. Here's the veteran outfielder, Jock Peterson.
Leading off for the Giants, the left fielder, number 23, Jock Peterson.
The right-hander back to work. Inside corner for a strike. Righty to the plate. Got him. One out in the second. Up to the plate is Brandon Belt.
The designated hitter, Brandon Belt.
In there, and it's 0-1. Offering misses, and now it's even 1-1. Our umpire behind the plate, Jerry Hillsdale. High praise for Jerry when we talk to people around the game.
Yeah, no doubt about it, Boog. He's very straightforward, very consistent back there. So most of the time, you're not even going to think about him. That's a good thing.
Next offering is in for a strike. What about some no-nos? Like, you can't call the umpire blue the way you do in Little League or high school, right?
Yeah, even in the minor leagues, you'll learn quickly. You call the umpire blue. You better learn his name. And that's just part of being a professional player and even a major league player.
The pitch. Pulled down the line. This one hammered, but it's fouled.
That was a nice bid right there to try to tie up this ball game. Just couldn't keep it from bending foul. He looked locked in on that swing. Pitcher better be careful with him right now.
Backed off the plate that time. Ground ball scooped up. Key Brian Hayes. Throw not in time. It's an unlikely infield single.
That is good.
Runner on at first with one gone. Tyro Estrada to the plate. Next pitch downstairs, and it's 1-0. And the righty deals. Fouled off. He was late. And a pitch. And there's a foul ball. Swing and a foul. Pushed off to the right. And that will get out of play. Next offering is downstairs. And he grounds one to the right side. And it goes just foul. Hit on the ground, might be two. To second, there's one. Double play. And that'll do it for the inning. Now to the bottom of the second. It's the Pirates 1 and the Giants nothing. Back here at PNC Park, here's the rookie right fielder, Cal Mitchell.
Leading off for the Pirates, the right fielder.
And Cal. Here it comes.
Mitchell.
That one ripped right center field. And out of here. Third home run of the season, and they add to their lead. It's 2-0.
This eye-hand coordination to be able to get that splitter and still get the barrel to it, get it up in the air for a home run. Tell you what, these guys worked so hard at their craft, and right there, it was on display.
And here is Diego Castillo.
Batting seven. Not shortstop.
In there for strike one.
Always exciting to see a leadoff home run in an inning. Kind of gets the offense fired up, and you start to expect a big inning.
The wind of the pitch. Out towards right center field. Yastrzemski racing over to make the catch.
Batting it. The catcher. Michael
Perez. The next Pirate to hit. And that's in there for strike one.
0-1.
The wind of the pitch.
Ball. One ball, two strikes.
Swing and a miss. Struck him out. That's the second out.
Thought it was a pretty good pitch. Top of the strike zone. We're seeing more fastballs in that location. Hitters,
baseman.
Especially
Four.
With two strikes, have to be ready to pull Four. The trigger.
Two outs. Base is empty. Here's the second baseman, Hoy Park. That one's in there, 0-1. Right-hander kicks, deals. And now the count is even. Next one misses, and it's 2-1. Next offering is down low. Three balls and a strike. Pitch. Bounce to the right. Tosses to first. Inning over. Pirates tack on one more on the solo home run. It's now a 2-0 ball game. Back here at the ballpark. And now here is Tommy La Stella.
Leading off for San Francisco, the first baseman, number 8, Tommy La Stella.
Keller back to work. And that's downed away.
Ball one, no strike.
To the right side. On to first. And one away in the top of the third.
Batting it. The shortstop, Brandon Crawford.
Here's Brandon Crawford. This is a guy who's in the lineup first and foremost because of what he contributes defensively, Chris. And when you talk about preventing runs from being scored, this guy is a big contributor. And a base hit into right. So they get a man aboard with a one-out single.
Well, a swing like that can help you come out of the struggle. We saw the numbers coming into the ball game. But all he's trying to do at this point is help his team win.
And here's the catcher, Austin Wins. In there, and it's 0-1.
I was always told it's hard to take you off the field when you play really good defense, especially at a premier position, and that's what he does.
Well struck left field. That one's deep. That one's back. And it is gone. With one swing, he quiets the crowd, and we're level. It's 2-2.
Power versus power right there, like two locomotives colliding. Who's going to win? But a really good job there by the hitter, getting the top hand working. Powers that fastball out of here.
Luis Gonzalez, the next Giant to hit.
Right fielder, Luis.
Next pitch has popped up. Park has a beat on it. And there's two down.
The center fielder, number 5, Mike Yastrzemski.
Two outs, base is empty. Mike Yastrzemski, the next Giant to hit. First offering misses the mark. The next pitch misses, and that's ball two.
Well, he looks more focused at the plate and working the count after that first at-bat strikeout.
Two oh. And there's a strike. Good heater at 98. And a pitch.
Ball three.
Tied up here in the early going. You say you win. In the air, left field. He makes the grab, and that'll do it. Ah, when the Giants go deep, it's bye-bye, baby. And we're deadlocked now at 2 apiece. And welcome back. Bottom of the inning. And now the Pirates leadoff man, P. Brian
leadoff
Hayes.
For the Pirates, the third baseman,
the pitch.
P. Brian. Hey.
Called strike right there. Oh, and one now. Base knock center field. Man aboard on the leadoff single.
Just so sound in his mechanics. Hits against a firm
fielder,
front side.
10.
And the hands just continue to carry through Reynolds. The middle of the field.
You too. Brian Reynolds here. Cobb checks the runner, and he dives back in safely.
Let's go, Pirates.
And the first pitch misses for ball one. On a line out towards center. Yastrzemski racing over to make the catch.
Man, that's one of those at-bats where you have to remind yourself it's about the process. He did everything right there. Nothing to show for it. But in your mind, you have to convince yourself that it was a very good at-bat.
Here's Daniel Vogelback. First pitch, and he just misses. And the 1-0. In for a strike, and a count even at one.
He's trying to stay away from this lefty, knowing that a lot of left-handers like the ball down and in.
And a pitch. That just misses, and it's 2-1. The pitch. And fouled off. Vogelback stays alive. Comes a 2-2. On the ground, right side. Base hit. That was smoke through the infield. They fired in quickly. So it's first and second with only one away.
Well, patience and discipline paid off right there as he got into an advantage count. There's nothing cheap about the way he got that one through the infield. That was ripped, caught out front, and didn't get under it like he would have liked, but definitely put a good swing on. Now a huge at bat in this game coming up.
And Michael Chavis will get a chance to hit. Comes a pitch. One out. Runners at first and second. Here's the pitch. It's a double steal. And that one ripped to left. And a base hit. Runner from second crosses the plate. It's 3-2.
Well done. Drives in the run. Nice line drive to the full side. Bedded out front, but just stayed through it nice enough and ripped it into the outfield.
Here's the left fielder, Jack Sawinski.
The batter, the left fielder.
Jack. Swung on, belted.
Sawinski.
That's back. And that one is out of here. A three-run homer, his 11th of the year. It's 6-2.
There he got a splitter that he was able to handle, allowed that pitch to travel a little bit deeper, and when it was time to commit, his hands exploded through the zone.
Cal Mitchell to the plate here.
The right fielder, number 31. Cal.
First pitch doesn't find the zone. The 1-0. And there's a ball.
Clearly, he hasn't had it in this game, and looks like sooner than later, they're going to have to go to the bullpen.
The wind to kick the 2-0. Line to left, and foul ball. Righty delivers. That's outside. Now 3-1. On the ground, right side. Gathers and throws to first. That's it out.
The batter, number 64.
Diego Castillo, the next Pirate to hit. And And first offering is fouled off. The 0-1 is outside, and it's a ball and a strike. Next pitch is outside. Next one misses, and the count is 3-1. To the right side. Tosses to first. That ends the inning. Three-run shot for the Bucks in the inning. It's now 6-2. As we go to the top of the fourth, and now Wilmer Flores
leading off for San Francisco.
The Giants in striking distance, but have some work to do.
Boog, it starts with the leadoff man. Need a good at bat out of him right here.
And he deals just off the outside edge. Kicks and deals. That's ripped to right down the line. Bounces over the wall in foul ground. It's an automatic double.
The automatic double kind of feels now like batting. Enjoying cruise control in your car, boy. You don't need to keep the pedal down as you cruise into second base. Just no worries in the world. You know what? He put a really good swing on that one.
So, man aboard. And now Jack Peterson. First offering misses badly for ball one. Next one is off the play. Two balls, no strikes to count. Runner at second, nobody out. Next pitch is popped up. Hayes under it. And there's one down.
Oh, that's a frustrating end to the at bat for the hitter right there. I mean, that pitch was right down the middle. I think he got a little too excited, came out of his mechanics, and instead of driving that ball somewhere, he popped it up. Unfortunate for him.
Next is the designated hitter, Brandon Bell. First pitch, and that's in for a strike.
He's pitching well, but not throwing a ton of first pitch strikes. Usually doesn't work out for success, but you can never predict baseball.
That one close, ruled a ball, and it's a ball and a strike. Hammered, and now maybe extra bases. Flores coming home. He'll score easily. It's 6-3. Pulls into second. That's an RBI double.
Well, that gets him a little closer in this one. Put a really nice balanced swing on it. And when you can rope one into the gap like that, you're thinking extra bases from the first couple of steps out of the box. And he'll feel real good about that one.
One out, runner at second. Stepping in, Tyro Estrada. In there for strike one. Here's your one. Now a high fly ball out to left center. Reynolds under it. It is caught to the out.
The first baseman, number 8, Tommy.
So two down now, and here is Tommy La Stella. Rolled out to second in his first at bat. Pitch misses inside, ball one.
Boog, he never moved because he never had time to. But that kind of velocity, you'd prefer that pitcher work away.
In the air to left center, Reynolds on the move to his right, makes a nice grab at a full sprint, and that is that. But a run will score in the inning on this RBI double. It's now 6-3. Ready to go, bottom four. Here's the catcher, Michael Perry.
Leading up for the Pirates, the catcher, Michael.
And the pitch.
Perry.
And that one just misses, a ball and no strikes. Kicks and fires.
Here we go. Two balls, no strikes.
That clips the corner. Out there to center. Yastrzemski makes the catch, and there's one down.
Up next for Pittsburgh, the second baseman, Hoy Park,
the next Pirate to hit. That's in there for strike one. Line drive, base hit.
The third baseman, number 13.
They're back in trouble, Boog, and it's just been like this for him most of the game. They've been all over him since his first pitch, and I think he's got a very short leash right now. Really needs to lock it down here.
Now batting Keith Ryan Hayes.
Count 1-0.
Cobb checks the runner. Park back on a dive. At the belt, fires. The kick and the pitch. Runner goes. Throw to second.
Well, I really didn't expect him to try to steal second base because he had a very standard lead at best. You're going to try to get there safely. You've got to get more on that lead. You've got to get a better jump. That was the difference between being safe and out.
Two-oh. That one the other way. That's a fair ball down the right field line, and that's going to kick into the corner. And into second easily with a two-out double.
Really shot that one down the right field line and somehow found a way to keep it from slicing foul. One thing that was great about the approach, his head was down all the way through the pitch, and that's how you do it.
Digging in, it's the speedy outfielder, Ryan Reynolds.
Now batting, center fielder, Ryan Reynolds.
And he swings and misses, and it's nothing at one. Pitch. Good eye in that spot.
Well, the good thing so far is that he hasn't issued any free passes. Unfortunately, they're making pretty good contact, so not getting the swings and misses and making that defense work behind him.
Runner leads away at second. This ball is hammered deep center field, way back there, on its way out of here. Ryan Reynolds leaves the yard, his 12th of the season, and they add on. It's 8-3.
Anytime you have a pitch down the middle of the plate, the percentages go up for the hitter to do damage, even if it's a pretty good sinker like that one. Nice piece of hitting there at the plate.
Here comes the skipper, and we're going to see a pitching change in this spot. Alex Cobb, done for the afternoon, and as he heads off, we'll step aside for a minute. Back with the new pitcher after this break. A new arm into the game, the righty, Dominic Leone. He has a great slider with tons of movement.
Dominic.
So at this point in the ball game, we're talking about middle innings, and you need a little length out of this arm coming out of the bullpen. We'll see just how many outs he's able to give his skipper.
Daniel Vogelback at the plate.
Now batting, number 19.
In there, and it's 0-1. You're one and fouled off. And a swing and a miss, and that's that. Another look at this two-run homer for Pittsburgh. It's now 8-3. Back here in Pittsburgh, new inning getting started. And now the shortstop, Brandon Crawford. Singh, you talk about a guy that has all the skills. The range is really good, but the arm just stands out, and he makes all the plays. The right-hander back to work. And a strike on the outside edge.
And because of that big power arm, he's able to play a little bit deeper, make throws from the outfield grass all the way across the diamond, and still get a pretty good runner. That's impressive.
Ball one. Next offering misses, and the count is 1-1. In the air, out towards right center. Reynolds racing over to make the catch.
Now batting the catcher, Austin.
Now it's the Giants catcher, Austin Wins. He's already homered in this one.
Well, on the mound, very efficient, able to produce an outcome, it seems like, within the third or fourth pitch of just about every at bat.
Ripped on a line. Sawinski makes the grab. Yeah, there's two away.
Now batting, right fielder, Luis.
So up next, Luis Gonzalez. First pitch, and that's in for a strike.
Pretty impressive. We haven't seen that pitch from him much, but he's got a really good feel when he throws it.
That hits the dirt, and 1-1. Two down, nobody on. Puts it in the air out towards left center. Sawinski makes the catch, and that'll do it. Nothing doing there for San Francisco. Can't chip away at an 8-3 deficit. Ready to go for the last half of the inning. Leading off, Michael Chavis.
Leading off for the Pirates, the first baseman, Michael Chavis.
And here it comes. Here's a rocket out to left. Peterson makes the grab.
Clearly ready to hit right there. First pitch of the inning, hits a bullet. Just one of those bad luck ABs.
Now the left fielder, Jack Sawinski. Good power, not great in the OBP department. swing, and that ball smashed on a line. No trouble here. Puts it away for the out. That's out number two.
Man, he smoked that fastball. He's all over it. It's just frustrating when you can't get it to fall. Maybe next time up, they'll find a hole.
So digging in, Cal Mitchell. Check swing, but he went too far. 1-1. Right-handed reliever, and it's even up.
1-1.
Check swing, appeal down to third, and he went around. Ruled a swing. The 1-2. That misses the zone. Two balls, two strikes to count with two outs. Righty to the plate. Got him. And good work there as he gets a 1-2-3. Nothing doing here for Pittsburgh, but they lead it 8-3. Back here at PNC Park. Now here is Mike Yastrzemski.
Leading off for the Giants, the center fielder, Mike Yastrzemski.
The pitch. And a good eye there.
That's where you want it. It's a good miss.
Laced down the line, and now maybe extra bases. Now he'll turn it for second. He makes it safely with a leadoff double in the sixth. Man, Siggy, he hit that ball right on the sweet spot. According to StatCast, the exit velo 110 miles an hour.
Yeah, Boog, I mean, that right there is an absolute missile. And he just put a great swing on it, squared it up perfectly. Those are the ones that feel really good.
And the batter now, Wilmer Flores. First offering, misses the mark. No outs, runner on second. That's a laser base hit. Stop sign goes up at third. Runners at the corners. Nobody out. That ball was absolutely ripped. 111 off the bat. And I'm pretty sure it started to whistle after it left the bat.
I think I heard that too, Boog. And these are the moments we appreciate when we can look at StatCast and just see exactly what the data is. Always so much fun to see what numbers pop up.
Here's Jack Peterson. And that one hit to first, and that's just foul. And now it's even up. Now a screamer into the outfield. Puts the squeeze on that one. Runner tagging from third. He's in there.
The batter, number 9, designated hitter, Brandon Bell.
And up next for San Francisco, Brandon Bell.
Now, this guy's definitely looking for a big swing of the bat right here. Try to close that gap. But, you know, at the very least, if you could find a way to manufacture that run from first, it feels like it's really important to getting back into this ballgame.
On the ground, could be two. Steps on the bag for one. Tag. It's second. It's a double play. And just like that, the inning is over. 7-8-9 due up in the home half of the inning. It's the Pirates 8 and the Giants 4. Welcome back. Well, we go bottom six. Here's the shortstop at the plate, Diego Castillo.
A shortstop, number 64.
and a pitch. And that's in for a strike.
0-1.
Right-hander kicks, deals. And a swing and a miss there.
Just a really nice slider down and in there. He wants to get the hitter thinking fastball, speed him up, and just subtract some velocity and add a little movement.
And a pitch. Three. And down on strikes he goes. One away.
Well, that at bat seemed to be over as soon as it started. Three-pitch strikeout. You've got to be better at the plate right there. At least to foul something off. Extend that at bat.
Michael Perez, the next Pirate to hit. Pitch misses inside, and that's ball one. Worm burner into the outfield for a knock.
Right there, does a great job of staying in the big part of the field. Man, there are a lot of hits there.
Now it's the second baseman, Hoy Park. And the first pitch misses for ball one. Next offering is in for a strike.
One and one.
Left hand batter waits. And now two balls and a strike. Popped in the air, left field. Peterson makes the grab.
Now batting, third baseman, Steve Ryan. Hey!
Keith Ryan Hayes, the next Pirate to hit. When you talk about elite defensive third baseman, this guy is at the top of the list.
Stud. When you look at players like this, you play that hot corner. Got to be pretty courageous over there with the way balls come off the bat. That's the kind of guy that every year you expect him to be in the All-Star game and have a gold glove, if not a platinum glove.
The pitch. In the dirt, blocked. Now 2-2. Way high.
Great RBI spot here. Just got to stay focused on the pitch. The runner will be in motion, so something in the gap should definitely score.
The 3-2 is off the outside edge, and that is ball four.
Well, he earned his trip to first right there. It's not easy laying off pitches that just missed the zone like that. And it's a real discipline as well. He's put a lot of work into that aspect of his game, and it paid off right there.
Reynolds stands in here, leaves that one off the inside. First and second, two down. The next offering misses, and it's 2-0.
Tough spot right here, a couple runners on, two ball count. You can't nibble, but you have to execute and finish your pitch. If you leave something out over the plate, it's going to bring in some runs.
Next offering upstairs. 3-0 down. Fought off foul. Swing and a ball hammered left field. That one's deep. Pulls it in on the warning track. Pirates strand a couple, but they still lead it by a count of 8-4. Back here at the ballpark, here's the second baseman, Tyro Estrada.
Leading off for the Giants, the second baseman, Tyro Estrada.
The right-hander back to work. On the ground, and he can't come up with it.
Late in the game with the offense trying to play catch-up, they're looking for any momentum they can get, any kind of opportunity to get back in this game, and an error can certainly do that. Let's see if that turns into something right here.
Runner at first following the error, and digging in for San Francisco, Tommy La Stella.
If you're going to get something going, this is the time to do it. You get the leadoff man on. Everybody's got to look over the shoulder and say, I'm just going to keep the line moving. Don't try to do too much.
Runner at first with no outs here. And a foul ball left side. Next pitch is inside, and a count 2-1. Next one misses, and now 3-1. Bounce to the right side, and that one finds its way through. Lead runner holds up. They're at first and second with nobody out.
Now
that could be a dangerous pitch if you don't get it inside enough, because as a hitter, you see it coming across the plate.
And the Pirates manager making his way to the mound now as he will make the move. Mitch Keller out of the game. And as he heads for the dugout, we'll take a quick break. New arm on the mound when we get back. They hand the ball over to a new arm, Anthony Bonta. This southpaw has been really good against left-handed hitters.
Bonta.
Always we know. Just some things we show. Oh, cool hat trick.
Now, Brandon Crawford. Ball. First pitch just misses.
Ball one, no strike.
No outs, runners at first and second.
Let's get him down right here.
Next offering is in for a strike. And a pitch. This one high in the air to left center. Snags it on the run. And that is a big first out.
Now batting. Catcher, Austin Wynn.
Austin Wynn's the next Giant to hit. In there for strike one.
Really good job in this spot to get ahead in the count. He's going to have to continue, finish off this hitter.
Yo-one. Swing and a miss as he chases that one darting out of the zone. Squirts away a little bit. Here comes a pitch. That one way outside. And that's ball two. And now the lefty got him looking. Two away.
Well, definitely a borderline pitch right there. And he didn't look too convinced as he headed back to the dugout. You know, those are tough ones to let go as a hitter. But with the human umpire calling balls and strikes, it's always going to be on you to protect yourself with two strikes.
Back to the leadoff spot of the Giants lineup. Luis Gonzalez, the next Giant to hit. And that's in there for strike one. Two outs, couple of base runners at first and second. Slapped foul. Gonna count one and two. There's a swing and a drive. Back there. That one is gone. A three-run rocket, his fourth home run of the season. And they tack on three. It's 8-7.
He got on plane with that high fastball, then look how his bat stays in the zone for a long time. Absolutely crushed that pitch.
Base is empty with two away. And the batter now, Mike Yastrzemski. Number five. Mike. In there, and it's 0-1. The tying run at the plate.
Ooh.
Next offering is in for a strike. On the ground to the left. Zips it to first. And that is that. Giants move closer with a homer this inning. It's now 8-7. Set for the last half of the seventh. Digging in, Daniel Vogelbach.
Leading off for the Pirates, the designated hitter, number 19.
Pitch misses outside, and that's ball one. Bullpen activity starting up now. Jose Alvarez getting loose out there. And the 1-0. This one is smashed down the right field line. Way back there. There and gone. Daniel Vogelbach blasts one out. Home run number 10 on the year. And they tack one on the board. It's 9-7.
This kind of velocity is so critical that you move the ball around real quickly and make sure that you keep that hitter off balance. Clearly not fooled by the location or the velocity, but he was all over that fastball.
So the Giants with a new pitcher on the hill, Jose Alvarez. And his job is to collect quick outs and keep his team within striking distance. Here's Chavis now.
Now batting, first baseman, Michael
First pitch, and that's in for a strike. Next one is off the plate, and it's 1-1. The 1-1. Swing and a tapper that rolls foul. The 1-2. That misses the zone. It's 2-2. Out to short. Whips it to first. One away. That ground ball may have him back on track after the homer.
The batter, the left fielder.
Sawinski stands in now, looks at that one inside. That's downstairs and outside.
Let's win, Pirates, come on.
The pitch. And that's outside.
At this point in the game, you cannot issue free passes. He's going to have to challenge this hitter. Hitter's got to be ready to swing it.
And the pitch. There's the strike of the knees. And a 3-1 on the way. A strike. And he deals. And he walked him.
What a battle. It's not always easy laying off a 3-2 pitch, and I tell you what, he earned that ball.
Number 31, Cal Mitchell.
Mitchell stands in now and watches strike one.
Is there a little wrinkle to that? I think there was.
Yeah. A little slider action.
Next pitch misses, 1-1. Kicks and fires.
Pretty easy to give up on that pitch right there. Started on the edge of the plate with the spin. You know it's going to finish well off the plate.
Kicks and deals. Ground ball left side, and it goes just foul. Two and two. The punch out there, two away. Man at first. Now it's the shortstop, Diego Castillo. That one fouled off. Hard grounder into the outfield for a knock. The throw is wild and it gets away.
Really nice job staying up the middle with his approach. He didn't try to do too much with the pitch. Just shot it through the infield.
Up next for the Pirates, Michael Perez. First pitch, and he just misses.
looking for some insurance, or as our friends down in the South would say,
insurance.
No matter how you say it, we know what you mean.
The lefty, the 1-0. Hard hit, right side. Fires over to first. That ends the inning, and they limit the damage. One in the inning for the Pirates on this solo homer. It's now 9-7. Chris Stratton comes on now, and he has some nasty breaking stuff.
Number 46.
They know that he can get a right-hander out, but he's in position to face a couple of lefties this inning.
And welcome back. Ready to begin the eighth. Now the third baseman, Wilmer Flores.
Third baseman, Wilmer Flores.
And here it comes. And the first pitch misses for ball one. Meanwhile, activity in the bullpen. David Bednar loosening up in case he's called upon by Derek Shelton. The 1-0. Swing and a high fly ball out there towards left field. No trouble here. Puts it away for the out. And there's one down.
The batter, the left fielder, John Peterson.
Jack Peterson stands in.
Pirates, let's go.
That one hammered center field. That's back there. Pulls it in on the warning track.
Nevada, number 9, designated hitter, Brandon Belt.
Two outs, base is empty. And now the DH, Brandon Belt. And first offering is fouled off. Left-hand hitter waits. That's off the mark, and that is ball one. The other way. And they get Belt for the out, and that is that. Giants go down quietly. They still trail by a couple. It's 9-7. Now here's Tyler Rogers out of the pen.
Now
32nd appearance.
Number 71, Tyler Rogers.
Ready for the bottom of the eighth at the plate. Hoy Park.
Leading up for the Pirates, the second baseman, Hoy Park.
The pitch. That's down and in.
It's getting squeezed a little bit here late.
Next offering is in for a strike.
1-1.
At the belt and fires. And a count 1-2. And he chases that one. And that's the first out.
Oh, really went aggressive in with that slider. Good two-strike
now
pitch right there.
Third
at
baseman.
Worst case scenario,
Keith
it's
Ryan.
Weak contact in play. Exactly where he and the catcher wanted it.
And now, Keith Ryan Hayes.
Trying to steal a first pitch strike with the breaking ball right there, but he was all over it in the box. Kind of sets up an interesting at bat the rest of the way. A little chess match here.
Out towards left center, Peterson flying after this one. Racing, makes the catch. And there are two outs.
That's now just a really nice catch the on field. The run right there. He saved extra bases for sure. Probably needs a second to catch his breath. If the pitcher's his friend, he'll give him a second to catch his breath before he's ready to deal the next pitch.
Ground ball to Bill. That's a base hit.
All over that one right there. He wasn't able to elevate it, but he put a great swing on it. Right on time, good balanced approach, and just blasted it through the infield. And now they've got some speed on first, so we'll see if they try to get him into motion.
Vogel back in the box with two gone and takes a look at a called strike. Two now stays alive. Next pitch misses way outside. Tap to first, and he grabs it, foul. And the right-hander deals. Rolled softly, but that goes foul. And a 1-2 again. Slice the other way, that's a base hit. Throw stops the lead runner at second. Two on and two out.
The first baseman, number two.
So first and second with two outs. Next, it's the Pirates cleanup hitter, Michael Chavis. That one's in there, 0-1. And the righty deals. And a foul ball.
You know, he can move the ball around, add and subtract, get some weak contact at times. So you don't worry as much about him.
Oh, this ball's down, and that could bring in a run. Not in time. He's safe.
Big at bat to pad their lead up to three. Put a great swing on that ball. Took the barrel right to it. Nice extension as well. 105. Exit velocity. That tells you everything you need to know about that swing.
In the air, left field. Peterson under it. Makes the catch. And that will end the inning. But the RBI single pushes across a run. Last chance coming up for the Giants. David Bednar on the pitch here, and he'll do his best to hang on to this lead.
Number 51, David Bednar.
Back here in Pittsburgh, all set to start the ninth in this one. And digging in for San Francisco, Tyro Estrada.
Tyro Estrada.
And the pitch. Foul ball there. Right-handed reliever, a little bit low. And that skips in the dirt. 2-1 now. And that one fouled off. The pitch. Swings and misses. And the leadoff man retired here in the ninth.
Well, the first batter, it's always a big one for the closer. You get that punch out, you get settled in, you feel like you're in command out there on the mound from the jump, and kind of prevents any doubt from creeping into your mind or the guys that are playing behind you that, you know, you're going to wrap this thing up.
LaStella in the box with one away as he takes ball one. Now fly ball to right center. And there's two down.
The bat, number 35, hit by Brandon.
Two outs, base is empty. And the batter will be the shortstop, Brandon Crawford. First pitch doesn't find the zone. Two outs. Crawford checks his swing. Appeal down to third. And he held back, according to Rusty Valentine. Just one out away. Trying to close it out. And it is 2-1.
Well, so many hard-throwing relievers in the game these days, you would think that guys have made the adjustment, but I don't know if you ever get used to it. Just pumping gas out of the bullpen, so hard to play catch-up.
The 3-1, and that's ball four.
Boo, do you think you could draw a walk in the bigs if we gave you enough at-bats?
Oh, that's a good question.
I think that if they gave the pitcher a false scouting report on me, yes, I think I could draw a walk. And first offering is fouled off. And a pop-up, right side, foul territory. And he's got it, ball game. And the Pirates slug their way to a win in this one.
With this win, these guys tie the 1916 New York Giants 26 wins in a row. It's just hard to fathom if you go back to win number one to think that 25 games later, they would still be in the winning column. Just an incredible job. This is amazing to watch right now.
And your final 10-7. For Chris Singleton and our entire crew here at MLB The Show, thanks for stopping by. I'm John Ciambi. Talk to you soon.
Final line score this afternoon. First for the victorious Pirates, 10 runs on 16 hits. One error, they left 7 men on base. For the Giants, 7 runs on 9 hits. No errors, they left 4 men on base. Time of the ball game, 4 hours and 17 minutes. Thank you for joining us here this afternoon. And we remind you to please drive home safely.